Remember, he had scripture and song. Garrett and somebody, what were their names, wrote volumes of little scripture and songs, and they put out little paperback books with all these songs, because all the charismatic churches were just going after it, you know. We were going to sing the scripture like this is going to take us into the millennium. Yes! You might be interested in reading my overview, 70 years overview of worship in the church. I'm 65, so not quite 70, but I've been in, you know, all those movements I told you about. In the 50s, we were either dreamy gospel courses, like, you know, heaven someday, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away, you know, something like that. Or we had really, really wordy hymns with theology in them. And most of the theology was okay.
Well, let's say part of it's okay. Well, John, I want to just dial this down a little bit.
The red knob.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, that's better. And 60s, we were kind of awakening to hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord, we love you, Lord, we love you. Oh, isn't that just feels good, you know? And then we went into charismatic, and it's like we got some nice, like, this is the day that the Lord hath made. No, that's a different one. This is the day. We had different versions, right? And so in the late 70s, we had the scripture and song. And so you see, we were on a journey. We were a long ways from God in the 50s. Now, we were believers. I don't mean in any way discredit our savedness. I'm talking about our perspective of God. He was a long ways away. I'll fly away. I'm not there now, of course. Everybody knows that. I'm not there. But someday I will be. So let me sing about that.
Right.
But I can't get there now, so we'll just try to sing about it till we get there. And then in the 60s, well, it's true.
It is.
In the 60s, we kind of, hallelujah, oh, I think he's kind of streamy around us now, you know? In the 70s, like, oh, I'm so good, I can sing his word now. This is good, I sing right out of the Bible. I don't have to sing theology, cold hard theology, I'm singing right out of the Bible. And so we were making journeys into him. So in the 80s then, instead of singing scripture and song like, he is Lord, he is Lord, he is Lord, he is risen from the dead and he is Lord. We changed the words to, you are Lord, you are Lord, you know, you are risen from. Oh, we can sing to God rather than about God. There's an evolution taking place. In the 80s and 90s, we began just having more and more songs about the oneness with God.
Yeah.
So I think we're in some kind of upwards mobile journey of being connected to God, not only just in our ascension kind of activity, but our songs are reflecting it. Now, one thing we got to do, this is a big deal. Talked about this last Sunday a little bit at one of the churches here in town, is that we're going to have to change the words of our songs.
Yeah.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome here.
Because
you're not here right now, and I'm just thinking about someday when you will be here.
Sure wish you would.
Come fill this place and flood the atmosphere. Because it's not here now, and I wish you would someday. Your glory, Lord, is what our hearts long for, because it's not here now.
But if we fast and pray.
You see, we're doing something to get right with God instead of just believing that he's here. He's here. Those are good songs. They're the best songs we had in the day. Each one of them served a very valuable reason. And we're not mad at them. We're not offended at them.
Right.
We're not holding grudges at anybody who wrote those songs or any congregation who still sing those songs. That's not the problem. That's not the issue. But our hearts are being enlightened to something fresh and new. And so we want our words to reflect the reality not only of now, but calling forth those things which are not yet as though they were. So, that's going to get
yeah,
me
that's
there.
A good one. Say that again.
Yeah. Our songs ought to be filled with song words that call for things which are not yet among us. We don't see them manifest yet. They are truly available in the Word of God, wherever my Bible is. They're available in the Bible, legally ours, but we haven't seen them yet, or at least we don't feel them. They're not manifest yet. Call them forth! Someone said back in the 80s, good man of God, pastor of Debbie's dad's church after he moved, and the guy says, do you want your church to be somewhere in 5 years? Write songs with words that will reflect where you want them to be in 5 years. That way they go home with those sentiments still ringing in their hearts, coming out of their mouth. Unfortunately, a lot of our words are from yesterday, and they cut our newfound faith off at the knees. And that's just not allowable. And so how do we change? Holy Spirit, you're welcome here. Holy Spirit, we're so glad you're here. You've filled this place and flooded the atmosphere. I forget how we do it exactly. Your glory, God, is what our hearts live for. So, you see, it just doesn't take too much. And you can still sing with anybody. Just tweak the words a little bit so you don't violate your heart. You know? Again, we're not offended at people. We're just trying to guard over, because out of our mouth, abundance, out of the heart. Ooh, I messed this up last week, didn't I? Out of the
abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks.
That's a tough one.
Another one. Delirious did the song Rain Down, and there's a lyric on the chorus. It's my heart is dry, but still I'm singing. Well, not everybody's dry when they're singing it. They might be full, and so Jesus culture changed the words. Some are dry.
Some of you.
Them are dry.
They just changed it. They released it. And some are dry.
I hope nobody has a guilty conscience, but it might be you.
Mark, you remember Nick Smith?
Yeah.
Remember the song, one of the songs that he wrote was, Holy Spirit, you are here and you love it.
Yes, I do remember that. Yes.
I got it on my phone. That's
a good one.
I was thinking of a song, Come Light the Fire Again.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Come Light the Fire.
No, it's all going. It's all burning.
Your fire's been lit.
And you see, someone says, well, you're just putting your head in the sand, and you're just kind of hiding the truth, you know, hiding the evidence. It's like, no, the truth is you have more glory in you right now than you ever realized.
New creation.
Yeah.
And so call it forth. Begin speaking to it. Don't subjugate it. Don't callous it over and put a casket over it with words that cut it off, you know. So just call it forth. Just speak to what's already resident. You have, and by the way, if you're in Christ, you are a what?
New
kinos. New kinos, you're a brand new species. So you're not somebody waiting for a you know, some kind of rain down, whatever. You know, it's already happening. Now, do we appreciate the stirrings of His presence? Of course we do. But you know what? And this is what I feel like right now. And then Mark, where's Mark Ryan? Mark Ryan, you're up next, okay? And then what I appreciate, my perspective right now is that the bottleneck is not on God's end. If you're wanting something, the bottleneck's not on His end. That's He said, I've already given you everything pertaining to
godliness.
That's pretty much everything, right? Given you everything.
Raised Christ from the dead dwells in you.
Perfect. Yes. And I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Where's the bottleneck? Right here between my ears. The bottleneck's here. So when I pray, oh God, would you release it? It's like, no, I should be praying. God, my mind needs to be expanded. It's a terrible bottleneck. It is defiling me. It's violating me because I'm needing to get a new mind. Now, it's beginning to be renewed. My spirit man is brand new.
Yeah.
is holy, complete, righteous, whole, seated in heavenly places, fellowshipping with the Father. It's, you know, it's, that's where my spirit man is. But what, right now, my biggest problem, I believe, is the thing between my ears. Mm-hmm. So I need to get it upgraded. That's Romans 12:2. Be ye transfigured, glorified, by what?
Renewing your mind.
Getting a new mind, yeah.
Change your stinking thinking.
Somebody said the other day, who was it said, you said, Earl, Heidi Baker says, less?
Oh, yeah. Too big, too small. Too big, too small.
Too big, too small. But it's growing. It's growing.